Well, I'm caught off guard. So the Mafia 2 and Mafia 3 Definitive Editions were recently released, unannounced, of course, and I'm very surprised because I looked at the screenshots when I got a notification on Steam, and I'm kind of disappointed. I looked at the screenshots, and while the graphics don't look too different to me, but I guess they might have improved them, and they claim that they're 4K resolution graphics, but to me, the game just doesn't seem any different. And not to mention, a lot of reviews are saying that the game is bugged, and it's just totally, like, terrible, buggy, glitchy, all kinds of things. And they're also saying that the game seems like it was made very quickly. And I do agree, the game, it looks to me like it was put together very, very quickly and that they didn't put too much time into it. And it's disappointing because when you watched my earlier video on Mafia 2 Definitive Edition, when I talked about what I wanted to see in the game, I thought they would add more stuff and make it more enjoyable and add new features at the very least. But when you look at the screenshots and you read the reviews, people are saying that this is no different than the classic version and that the graphics are not that much better and most of the game is buggy or glitchy. So I don't know what to say. It's depressing. It's disappointing that a great game such as Mafia 2 made by a good development studio is ruined by Hangar 13. So that's not good. I'm not happy about that, but I'm not too mad because going along with this announcement with this release of Mafia 2 and Mafia 3 Definitive Editions, they announced coming later this year, Mafia Definitive Edition. That's right. The original Mafia is being remade for new consoles and PC, and it's going to have your favorite character, Tommy Angelo. Yes, the Tommy Angelo that you play in the original. So you have him, and you're playing as him in the game again, but this time it's remade from the ground up with modern next-gen graphics. Now, it's way different from the Definitive Editions that we got for Mafia 2 and Mafia 3. This is a complete remake built up from the ground, and we're actually going to have better looking graphics and a completely new engine. I think they're running on a new engine on this new remake. So there's definitely upgrades on this version as compared to minor upgrades on Mafia 2 Definitive Edition and Mafia 3 Definitive Edition. So we have here the Mafia Definitive Edition, which is basically, you know, the original game, but with, you know, upgraded graphics. I know a lot of people were talking about this game and how they wanted 2K to remake this game and give it next gen graphics. I got that in the comments in my one video, and I was talking to people and they said that that's what they wanted to see. And it's great to see that they're doing this remake and they're building it from the ground up, because had they taken the original game and just did a remaster, it wouldn't have worked out. It wouldn't have worked out. The graphics would have looked terrible and it wouldn't have been a good fit for 2020 gaming. But since they're doing this with new graphics and a new engine and just rebuilding the game from the ground up, it looks good. It looks great. And it's going to be a good game. I never played the original. I'll admit that here. I got into the Mafia 2 version of the series when I had Xbox 360. But now that I played Mafia 2, and now that they're remaking Mafia the original, I think I'm gonna play it and give it a shot, because I've always wanted to try the original, but I just never actually got around to buying it or even trying it out. And I just only been playing the second one. But this will give me a real chance to buy the game and try it out. Looking at the Eurogamer article, the title says 2K formally unveils Mafia 1 remake details in Mafia 2 Trilogy Bundle. Now, the Trilogy Bundle is already available on Steam, and I'm sure on consoles as well. You can buy all three titles for $60, although Mafia 1 Remake isn't out yet, so that is on pre-order. You can also purchase the Mafia 1 Definitive Edition separately for $40. And I looked at this bundle, and then I looked at Mafia 2, and I saw that the remaster was not what I had hoped. But it seems to be, from my last video when I talked about what I wanted to see in the Mafia 2 Definitive Edition, about how I want to see a new engine, new features, new places to explore, all kinds of new things. It seems like that is going to be happening for this original Mafia game. It seems like the Mafia Definitive Edition is going to get the wish list that I wanted to see. So what we're going to see here from Mafia Definitive Edition is essentially just a full-on remake from the original game that is going to be built from the ground up. It's going to use a new game engine, and it's going to have new features, new gameplay features, an updated script, and it has additional cutscenes. Mafia 1 has a trailer released by 2K, and you can go and watch that. I'll link that in the description. That'll just show off, I guess, some of the early footage of the game and what it looks like. But to me, it seems like Mafia Definitive Edition is really just an entirely new remake that takes the original game and rebuilds it for next gen. and gives it the next-gen quality, the next-gen texture that it deserves. And looking by the screens here, which I will show on screen, it looks really good just based on the screenshots. Now, I don't know how the gameplay is going to play out in when it's released for the final version of the game. But to me, it looks from the screens only that this looks like a really good game and that this remaster will be really nice. The graphics look amazing. It's just, it's incredible. The cars look really good. The lighting is very smooth. Weather is great. And it looks like a nice open world game. Something that you would see made today, like from a new company, a new studio, not something that has been around for a while. This seems like an entirely new game just based on the textures alone and the new lighting effects and the weapon effects. That makes it look completely new, makes it look completely fresh, something that I think will attract many, many people to the game that have never played the original. So when you have new people playing this game that have never played the original, I think this will be a fan favorite for years to come. This one specifically, because it has the graphics, it has the features, it has the effects, it has everything that the original had for the nostalgic players, and it has all the stuff that really makes it a new and fresh game that the younger generation will enjoy. So other than that, there's not much information out on the game. There's not much information released about this game other than the trailer and other than what we have in this article. So it's not really set in stone what we're going to see, what's going to be in it, and things may change. It's coming out, supposedly the release date is August 20th, 2020. That's probably going to be the hard release date when it actually is published and released to the public. So that's what we got for the release date. That's what we have so far. Let me know what you think, because to me, this is a very big surprise. I thought they were doing Mafia 2 and Mafia 3, and that was it. I thought they were just doing those two, and that was going to be the releases for this year. I had no idea that there would be this secret rebuild of Mafia, the city of Lost Haven. I didn't think there would be like this unknown development of a next gen remake. I didn't think that would ever be a thing. And now I'm just blown away by what I've seen in the screenshots, what I'm reading about. It's everything I wanted for Mafia 2. But even though it's Mafia 1, I can't complain because I've wanted a game set in this 20th century time period. I've always wanted something like that, a next-gen looking game that is set in this early to mid 20th century time frame. So it's definitely something that I will be playing. It's definitely something that I want us to buy when it comes out. So let me know what you think. Let me know what you guys are curious. I'm curious what you guys think about this release, what you guys think about the news. This is definitely surprising. It's definitely something that I'm hoping it comes out to be a wonderful game, because I know Mafia 3 was a glitched and broken game, and Mafia 2 Definitive Edition is definitely broken and glitched. But hopefully with this release of a remake on a new engine, on a rebuild from the ground up, hopefully Hangar 13 can redeem themselves and make a wonderful game. I really hope they can, because we need a game like this. We need a game that's fresh, that's exciting, that's upgraded. And the only thing that could go wrong is if this game is buggy and glitchy. That's the only thing that could ruin this game. But other than that, this game is going to turn out fine. I hope so. And it looks great. It looks amazing. So I'm excited. I'm excited to play. I'm excited to buy it. I'll watch the trailer later on, and I'll take a look at what this game is going to be like. So once again, let me know in the comments what you guys think, what you guys are feeling, how this news impacts you, what you're hoping to see in this game when it finally releases, and your overall thoughts on this news. That's going to do it for this video. Thanks for watching. Thanks for supporting my channel. This is Dark Knight signing off.